those steeper things, so it's a chance to practice this morning as we head up. And if you have any questions about it, let me know. Marion will be our suite today. It's her favorite position. And if you need anything, she's awesome to hold. Your step range and can come up here, but it's a whole lot harder to push off if you step this high versus if you step this high. So it uses less energy and is more efficient to go step, step rather than
step, step,
step. Sometimes the terrain doesn't let you do that, but if you start thinking in your head of like, oh, how can I go? You'll actually use less energy and be less tired as you go. The other thing that's kind of helpful is, especially on steep terrain, is your calves can get really sore really quickly. So sometimes I'm looking for ways in which to support the back of my foot. So I might be able to sort of put my foot on a little micro edge so it stays flat, or I might have to turn it sideways. You don't always have to walk like this. You can go, as we say in mountaineering, el canard, like a duck. You can also step over and go sidestepping either direction to try to keep your foot as horizontal as you can. It just makes it less tiring over time. And this steep terrain tends to be super tiring, no matter where you're doing it, whether it's at sea level or high on a mountain. So again, find that rhythm, find your micro steps, and look at ways to keep your foot as horizontal as flat. Harder, and actually on mountains, more accidents happen going down than coming up. One, because people are tired, less hydrated, they've reached the goal, so they drop their attention sometimes, attention to going down. And also, when you come up, you're faced into the slope, and of course when you face out, you have this big, beautiful expanse of world to look at, so that can sometimes make folks a little more nervous. So some things to concentrate or think about when you're going down is, get very nervous about skittery little rocks and thinking, oh my god, they're gonna slide. So I actually just plan for them to slide. So in my mind, I'm always thinking, okay, this is gonna give way, and what am I gonna do when it gives way? And just have, usually try to have two or three steps mapped out in front of myself so that if it does skid, the really gravelly stuff typically doesn't send you super far, especially if you've got that kind of plan in your mind. The other is continuing just to look for those micro descent steps. So rather than taking the big huge step down, getting the, you know, again, the micro steps, so I might choose to go bing, 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 rather than bing, bing, bing. The other thing we talk about in going down is knees over toes, and actually you can make your feet grip really good by a little bit of a knee bend. So if you find yourself ever having to go down a slab of rock, you sort of bend the knees, and again, you see that most of my sole is in contact with the rock, so I can actually just come down here feeling pretty comfy because I got my knees and my nose and my toes all in alignment driving my entire